Hello at the start of this weekend, on the 22nd of October. Our opening prayer. God of the living word, open our ears to your message. Open our eyes to see your wonders. Open our hearts to experience your love. And open our minds to your wisdom today and every day. Amen. Our readings today are from the second book of Kings, chapter 17, verses 1 to 15, and Psalm 96. One of the main roles of the kings of Israel was that they were supposed to make sure that God's will was done here on earth. In the earthly kingdom they ruled over. Today we hear about the last king of Israel, Hushai. As we read about what he did, it becomes abundantly clear how far he's moved away from God's intended purpose, and what a deterioration it is. A James Bond script writer or John le Carré would have been really pleased if they'd dreamed up what is taking place in the 15 verses of this reading. But sadly, it's fact, not fiction. What we read is a classic tale of cross and double cross. And I don't know whether you spotted it, but there is no mention of God in those verses whatsoever. It's clear that Hushai is putting all his efforts into trying to work things out for his own advantage, no matter the cost or implications. With this in mind, it should come as no surprise to us that things don't work out as he hoped. And given the sorry state of affairs, it should also come as no surprise that God literally decides that this is the end of the line. What a contrast there is between Hushai and his focused self-centeredness and Jesus. Jesus, our heavenly King, spent all his life focusing on and working for others. And Jesus has that complete oneness with God the Father and God the Holy Spirit. Hushai wasn't even giving God a look. Our next prayer is for all leaders. Gracious Lord, we continue to pray for everyone who is in a position of leadership of any kind. As the weeks go by, the complexity of the situation and the decisions which need to be made become no easier. Pour your wisdom down on all leaders, and we pray that they follow your guidance. Amen. Our prayer points today start with praying for wisdom in the choices which we make every day. Then think about the people we regularly pass on the street and remember them in prayer. We may not even know their name, but at least we can describe them, and God knows them by name. And pray that we display godly compassion. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Tomorrow is Bible Sunday, and our service is at both of the churches in the benefice remain unaltered, here at St. Aidan's 9:30 and 11 o'clock. And St. Luke's continue to worship within St. Wilfrid's Academy at 11 o'clock. Our blessing. The glory of the Father, the peace of the Saviour, and the power of the Holy Spirit be within you and about you. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and your loved ones today and ever.